Aloha everybody, this is Christopher with AG Productions once again. I wanted to do a video tonight, sort of a Christmassy video, not really a super Christmas time, but got three miniatures in the mail today. All three are for a contest. This one that you see in front of you is for a contest that unfortunately ended a couple of months ago, or about a month ago, I guess. And it was an Avatars of War contest. The company I ordered this from had to actually order it from Spain, and it took a little while to get here, and then once it got here, there were some U.S. shipping problems, and so it didn't come in until today, but that's all right. But it's a really cool figure, so I'm going to paint it up anyway. You can see the completed figure there on the back. That's the actual green stuff figure, but a really, really sweet model. And it's got, it comes with a just a 25 mil base here, square, and just a really, really neat sculpt right there. I mean, just really cool. And if you're wondering why his hand looks kind of deformed, he's actually holding a ball of fire, so it looks a little weird. But once it's painted up, I think it'll look really nice. I've actually got a base that I built for this guy, specifically for him, before the contest was over, because I thought I was going to be into it. But it's this right here. I think this is a 50 mil base, maybe 40. Let me see here. No, it's actually 50. Yeah, let's see here. Make sure I try. Yeah, that's two of those. Okay, good. It's a 50 mil base. I did it sort of as a workshop style base, like a wizard's workshop within a castle. And what I was going to do was take a take some paint and run a semicircle from about maybe right here all the way up to about right here, and have inside that semicircle maybe some runes and then another semicircle running like that, sort of like he's trying to summon something just off the base on this side that you can't quite see, but that he needs a nice safety rune circle to block from coming out and attacking him, you know, just to give it sort of a little bit of character to the model. But that's the Avatars of War figure. Really cool figure, man. If the Avatars of War figure, they're not cheap at all. I think this guy was, I want to say he was $17, which is not exactly the least expensive miniature on the market. But the castings are excellent. They're all metal models. They're really, really well done. I would definitely recommend picking some up if you haven't seen them yet. Next up on the list is this set of models right here. This is called Rusted Heroes. This is actually made by Fantasation Miniatures. Now, Fantasation is actually a store, an online store. They're very similar to the War Store. I can put a link somewhere if you guys really want one. But the only difference really between them and the War Store is that they have no Games Workshop, but they do offer a few more obscure miniature lines. Things like Helldorado, which is just an unbelievably well-sculpted set of miniatures. They offer Enigma models, which are magnificent. I mean, just beautiful, beautiful models. They carry a lot of European miniatures versus the War Store, which tends to focus mainly on U.S. miniatures with the occasional European mini thrown in. But anyway, they have come up with a new game called Rusted Heroes, and the model here is called Lars. He's a Norse warrior, all right? And basically comes with your standard Privateer Press style 25 mil round base. And this guy is a, like some kind of a Viking warrior guy. He comes with this really nice two-handed axe. From the side, when I first saw him, all I thought was, why did they, well, let me do it this way. There we go. Camera up. There we go. See, look at that. It's coming in like that. All I could think was, why did they send me a Blood Bowl guy? Because that's what it looks like. He's like a Blood Bowl lineman. You know, it really does. But it's a really nice figure. Well sculpted, again. Actually sculpted by Ben Sines, who is one of Reaper's top sculptors. they didn't really spare any expense on the sculpting for these guys. They've got a lot of really well-known sculptors doing the models for these. My only problem that I see so far is that the antlers of the model are actually attached to the body, which is going to be a pain to separate them and like pull them up farther. But it's not anything that a, you know, an experienced modeler would have any difficulty doing. So, you know, other than taking the time to actually do it. But there you go. So that guy, you guys will get to see me paint him. And in fact, what I'm going to do is I'm going to stop doing the Warcaster for just a little while and get this guy and then his buddy over here, which is actually right above him, done. Because these guys are for a contest, and the contest ends at the end of August. And so, at the end of July. And so I need to get them finished like Ricky Tick, you know. But here's his buddy. This guy is, it's T-R-J-E, and running in Nordic terms, I'm going to pronounce it Terje, alright? It could be Terje, I don't think so, because he's not French. I'm pretty sure it's Terje, because he's supposed to be a Norse guy. But, this guy's a scout. Really, really nice looking model here. Can't really get... There we go. We can kind of see a few of the details and everything like that. It's got a bald head, but really cool guy. Comes with a big, like, Viking Celtic style sword. Flat and long, or flat and wide blade. Just really, really, super, super damaging kind of weapon. It also comes with a what appears to be a short bow that holds like that on the side, as well as a quiver of arrows, which I'm not exactly sure where to attach. Let's see here if I can find a hole or something that they would go into. Wait. Is that... Oh, yes, that is one. Look at that. Now, that's odd. Why would you put a quiver on your leg? I have no idea. Hey, there we go. Alright. Quiver goes onto the leg. Alright. But, this guy, really cool looking model. I was actually only going to get this guy until I saw the pose that this guy was in. And I realized I could make a really nice diorama with this guy. Well, a small diorama with that guy. And so, picked him up as well. But, yeah, there you go. So, that is all three minis that we picked up today. That came in the mail today, and hope you liked it. I've got a question for you guys too. Would you be interested in, because I've got so many companies that I am familiar with, and everybody out there, the majority of gamers know 1 to 2 to 3 companies. Most everybody knows GW, Reaper, and Rackham, and Privateer Press, okay? If anybody would be interested in learning about some of the other miniature companies that are out there, some of the more obscure companies that really produce nice minis that you probably would want to pick up if you knew they even existed, if anybody would be interested in learning about that kind of stuff, let me know, because I could probably do like a feature on one company a week and, you know, just pick some day of the week and do, you know, a 10-minute video on what the company is, what kind of minis they sell, and then maybe show a few if I have any, or just show some of their product pictures from their website or whatever. But just let me know if you guys would be interested in something like that. But that's it for today, guys. So I hope you enjoyed it, and God bless y'all, and I will see you next time.